Welcome to Proteal's production channel. Do you wanna subscribe to my channel before traveling the climax of knowledge again today? Don't forget to click on the bell. Let's start. Every minute, an average of 70 times the muscles in your heart transmit life fluid to the farthest parts of the body. Simply saying that this event ceases is death. However, losing control of this system is death. The derailment of this system from a shape will confirm high blood pressure. Blood pressure consists of two components, arterial systolic and diastolic. The systolic value is the pressure exerted on the vascular wall of the blood that is thrown from the heart towards the vessels when the heart contracts. The diastolic value is the pressure still present in the vessel wall when the heart relaxes. Even though it seems innocent, blood pressure is fatal. In the research conducted in 2010, death in the world due to blood pressure is 9.4 million people. 5,000 years ago, in the Chinese Empire, historically the treatment for what was called the hard pulse disease consisted in reducing the quantity of blood by bloodletting or the application of leeches. This was advocated by the Yellow Emperor of China and Hippocrates. For thousands of years, this was considered a treatment method. In the 19th and 20th centuries, before effective pharmacological treatment for hypertension became possible, three treatment modalities were used, all with numerous side effects: strict sodium restriction, sympathectomy, surgical ablation of parts of the sympathetic nervous system, although these days this method is for the treatment of excessive sweating, and pyrogen therapy, injection of substances that caused a fever, indirectly reducing blood pressure. Modern pharmacological treatment of the disease still used today, such as beta blocker and ACE inhibitor, was found in the 1950s. High blood pressure is classified as primary, essential, hypertension or secondary hypertension. About 90 to 95% of cases are primary, defined as high blood pressure due to lifestyle and genetic factors. Lifestyle factors that increase the risk include excess salt in the diet, excess body weight, smoking, and alcohol use. The remaining 5 to 10% of cases are categorized as secondary high blood pressure, defined as high blood pressure due to an identifiable cause, such as chronic kidney disease, an endocrine disorder, or the use of birth control pills. Hypertension is rarely accompanied by symptoms, and its identification is usually through screening, or when seeking healthcare for an unrelated problem. Some people with high blood pressure report headaches, particularly at the back of the head and in the morning, as well as lightheadedness, vertigo, tinnitus, altered vision or fainting episodes. These symptoms, however, might be related to associated anxiety rather than the high blood pressure itself. Hypertension is defined as either a systolic or a diastolic blood pressure measurement consistently higher than an accepted normal value. This is above 129 millimeters of mercury systolic, 89 millimeters of mercury diastolic. But it is a gradual disease. The first line of treatment for hypertension is lifestyle changes, including dietary changes, physical exercise, and weight loss. Their potential effectiveness is similar to and at times exceeds a single medication. Dietary changes shown to reduce blood pressure include diets with low sodium, vegetarian diets, and green tea consumption. Physical exercise regimens which are shown to reduce blood pressure include aerobic exercise and resistance exercise. Stress reduction techniques such as biofeedback or transcendental meditation may be considered as an add-on to other treatments to reduce hypertension. Then the medication is started. Most people require more than one medication to control their hypertension. However, the best treatment for you will find doctors who have given decades to do this. You only need to consult a doctor if you think you have high blood pressure. It is often neglected by people as it does not directly affect life. However, it is the number one cause of heart failure and strokes. Let's come to one of the most common mistakes: measuring blood pressure incorrectly. For an accurate diagnosis of hypertension to be made, it is essential for proper blood pressure measurement technique to be used. Improper measurement of blood pressure is common and can change the blood pressure reading by up to 10 millimeters of mercury, which can lead to misdiagnosis and misclassification of hypertension. Proper blood pressure measurement requires the person whose blood pressure is being measured to sit quietly for at least 5 minutes, which is then followed by application of a properly fitted blood pressure cuff to a bare upper arm. The person should be seated with their back supported, feet flat on the floor, and with their legs uncrossed. The person whose blood pressure is being measured should avoid talking or moving during this process. Although electronic devices make this whole process easy, there can often be errors. Also, make sure that the sphygmomanometer you will purchase has ESH, European Society for Hypertension, approval. You should be careful. As a result, it often causes problems if blood pressure is not controlled. Long-term high blood pressure, however, is a major risk factor for coronary artery disease, stroke, heart failure, atrial fibrillation, peripheral arterial disease, vision loss, and chronic kidney disease. As we always say, the best treatment is to prevent the disease in advance. However, you should not do this in the hypochondria. 30% of the world population suffers from this disease. Despite this, the human life has reached an average age of 70 years. Of course, the reason is modern medicine and keeping your body under control. Don't neglect yourself, stay healthy. My next video is the forgotten inhabitants of Central Asia, about Kyrgyzstan and its cultures. Stay on track. Sources of all the information said in this video are given in the description section. Please comment to make corrections or additions. If you still have not subscribed, you can subscribe and like the video. Take care yourself. Ciao ciao.